So welcome to the second part of Rostow's second stage of economic growth. So in this today's class, we can discuss on what is the second stage of economic growth. What is the second stage of economic growth as explained by Rostow in this stages of economic growth. So the second stage is said to be the preconditions for takeoff. And the first stage was the traditional society, and that we have discussed in last class. And if you have any doubt regarding, or if you missed that class, then you can see the link in the description box as well as in the comment box. It has been shared, so you can see or you can get those videos from the shared link. So in today's class, we can discuss on the second stage of economic growth as explained by Rostow. So before going into the second stage, we can make a rough analysis, or we can make a rough study of what was the first stage. So before going there, what is the who was Rostow, and all these things has been described in the first class itself. So he was an American economist as well as political theorist and professor who introduced this theory of economic stages for economic growth. So his major works were The Process of Economic Growth, it was in, published in 1953, Trends in Allocation of Resources in Secular Growth, 1955, The Stages of Economic Growth, published in 1960, which we are discussing now, and The Takeoff into Self-Sustained Growth in 1969. And this is very important concept, Cycle of Poverty. Cycle of Poverty in the sense that whenever a society is in a traditional condition, majority of its people is living in poverty, below poverty conditions. So they will be having low employment or lack of employment, or even there will be employment, but they will be paid less, or there exists some kind of slavery, or that is the situation. So they can't make more investment. There will be low investment that leads to capital deficiency for savings and low productivity, low real income and low savings. This is the vicious cycle of poverty. And we have to look at the traditional society, and the next stage is traditional transitional stage, or a stage of change. In between two important stages, there is some kind of transition or some kind of symptoms that shows some sort of improvements in their conditions. So when the traditional society shows some symptoms of improvements into development, that kind of changes or symptom is said to be the traditional stage or precondition, transitional stage or preconditions for takeoff. So in first traditional society, well, we have looked the characteristics of a traditional society. We have already discussed it is mostly agricultural based economies, and they produce their food for themselves, not for any commercial purpose, so they won't make any investments out of it. And most of the labor are intensive, and the society will be hierarchical, has been divided into different segregates. It has been divided into different segregates of people, in which very few people, or a kind of feudal system exists, and so very few people is having a more number of wealth, and all the majority, rest of the majority is depending or working for them. That is the kind of society exists in the traditional society, or in the first stage of economic development. But when there's excess or the particular society shows some kind of transitions or changes or some kinds of symptoms for development, there shows some kinds of symptoms, that is the transformation from rural to urban, or long or a very large family to some nucleated family, then their subsistence orientation will be formed into some planning kind of orientations, and little saving into some kinds of capital, more capital investment, and some sort of changes that drives them into improved form as showing in a particular kind of traditional society. That kind of traditional society that shows these kinds of transition is known as the transitional society or preconditions for takeoff. So the second stage is the preconditions for takeoff, and it is very commonly said to be the transitional era. Transitional in the sense that it makes some form of changes from the existing conditions. Sustained growth are created, or some sort of changes from the existing conditions will be created in that particular society. So what will be that kind of changes? We can look a brief history from Great Britain and Western Europe. It has been started, this kind of transition has been started, begins in during the later ends of 15th century, that is the ends of medieval age and in the beginning of modern age, and that is the reason why they call it as the modern age, because they transforms from a traditional, or they tries to transforms them from a traditional society into some sort of scientific improvements, or some sort of improvements in their way of attitudes and behaviors. So what are the four forces that leads to this kind of improvements in that particular society? Especially new learnings or renaissance. Renaissance in the sense that it is said to be the rebirth of knowledge. Till that time, some sort of power, some sort of dominations make them in a dark age, or we have a topic of dark age. We can do it in separate video classes. So dark age is a period when all sort of scientific development has been sealed by the religious power, because they believe in religious dominations or religious schools, which is not a kind of which is not having any scientific developments, or it won't give any scope for development in for discoveries or art, culture, anything like that. So but whenever a particular society shows some kinds of started learning new things through the flourish of education, the Renaissance may happen, a new monarchy may happen, and new world, new religion occurs. These are the driving forces that leads to the conditions of transitional society. So what is Renaissance? Renaissance in the sense, it is a French term, and it is known as the rebirth of knowledge of any kind, architecture, literature, art, everything is accepting in that particular society. They have the freedom of expressing things through their literature, arts, works, science, discoveries, etc. The people start showing human intelligence, showing beliefs in human intelligence, rationality, logical reasoning behind some superficial things, etc. These are the characteristics of an improving society. So some kind of change occurred from a an existing situation. An existing situation in the sense that faith and authority, faith in the sense that they believe fully on, they won't question back into any roles that has been laid by religion. And the authority, they will think that authority is the prime authority, and they won't make any voice against them. And they follow as slaves in that particular economy. But from this faith and authority, when the economy transformed into reasoning and skepticism, the people believe in logic, reasoning, and they start questioning. That kind of economy can be called as transitional. A kind of economy which has been explained by Rostow. So skepticism is the term which symbolizes the attitude of questioning attitude in people, especially towards supernatural, mortality, theism, and knowledge. And whenever some kind of beliefs has been existing in that particular society, the people will try asking questions against it. They find out the truth behind it. They find out the they have to know the correct logic behind it. So this kind of attitude is known as skepticism. So from a faith and authoritative society, it will transform to reasoning and skepticism. So the basic characteristics of the transitional society is, again, it will be based on some kind of logic, they believe in logic. They believe in logic in the sense they believe in science, and they believe in reasoning. They want to know the fact behind certain things, etc. And they when these kinds of knowledge has been flourishing, education is improving, then the people, very few people can't dominate the majority, because this majority is also getting educated, and they are also got enlightened to certain knowledge, and they have the power, or they start questioning these injustice towards them. So there will be definitely a kind of end to feudalism. Then the national states will arise, and a kind of spirit of adventure for acquiring knowledge, traveling, art, everything will evolve as a part of Renaissance. So the end results will be, there is a change in the social attitudes, expectations, structures, values from the existing society. From that particular society, they start improving, or they start transforming into that, into an upgraded form. So if the driving force, if we look, what is the driving force behind this change, then we can see that it is not endogenic. It's not endogenic in the sense that it all comes inside a particular country. It is because of the foreign invasion, a foreign invasion, or the foreign countries which is more dominant than that particular host country, is dominating that particular country which is following a traditional society, and they invade them. Then how this process occurs? Because we can understand this through a small example. Napoleon Bonaparte has invaded Europe. At that time, the European society was traditional society, but the ideas and attitudes brought by the armies of Napoleon Bonaparte has paid some kinds of chances for unification of Germany and Italy. And you can also think about India. Before British invasion or establishment of East India Company or British rule in India, and after British rule in India, till the invasion of British or making India as its colony, it was in a stage of traditional society, or it was not unified at all. It is dispersed in such a way, ways of princely states in various parts. So, but after the invasion of British rule, there comes a feelings of nationalism, Indian, and a united feeling. Only a united nation can invade this outside power. So there arise different struggles for freedom. So all these kinds of movement leads to the society into the next level. So this kind of nationalism is known as reactive nationalism because of the fear for foreign domination. So they struggle to have freedom from those people, those dominant imperialistic power. So the prime source, prime source for their development is mainly the fear for slavery and fear for domination from these foreign countries. So that makes people to think more about changes, and they spread education, and they somehow unifiedly come out from this domination. So this is the particular situation of confusions and struggles explained by Rostow in this second stage of economic growth. So in the next class we can look how this transitional stage further become the takeoff stage. So this is all about today's class, and I think I should say one tip for examination also, because many of us will study on multiple choice questions and one word questions, etc., because we sometimes we have to, because we have to rely on those multiple choice questions, etc., because we don't have much time. But if you have some time, or if you have interest, really interested in that particular subject, you have to learn the concept. If you learn the concept very well in a capsule manner, in your free times, you can just sit for take some small topic and study for 20 minutes and cover that small topic. For example, you can take the quantitative revolution from the geographical thought and study it. So in that manner, if you study in that manner, if you are thorough with the concept, then from anywhere the question comes, you can answer it. So this is a good way, I think. So it's up to you. Whatever you feel good, you can plan in that way to achieve your goal. Thank you. Thank you for watching.